What is going on, guys? It's Bro16 here. Today, I have the ultimate guide on how to earn badges for your big man in NBA 2K16. So, without further ado, let's get into it. First thing I want to show you guys is the attributes. As you see, I am a 93 overall power forward. I think it's essential that you guys know what you should be upgraded so you don't waste, you know, your precious VC on something stupid like playmaking, which I will get into in a little bit. But first thing you want to do is upgrade your rebounder, okay? I say this because at the very least, you'll be able to crash the offensive board or maybe defensive board, pass it out and get an easy assist, if nothing else at all. This is a very effective way of building up your VC, building up your teammate grade, and overall, you know, just getting the feel of how rebounding feels so different in this game, which I'll get into later on in this video. But once you do get a decent amount of VC, or if you do have a substantial amount of VC, one thing you don't want to spend it on is your playmaking. Playmaking is the biggest waste of VC you can ever do on your power forward. It is no point in doing this at all. Now, I know a lot of you are thinking, I always get ripped when I get a rebound. I always get ripped when I try to pass the ball. Even when I try to dribble or do a post, when I get ripped often and often. And I know, I agree, 2K needs to fix this, okay? But for the time being, don't waste your VC on it, because the max we can get is a 50 ball control. And we still get the ball ripped out of our hand, okay? So it's pointless. You might as well upgrade something actually useful. That's why I recommend you upgrade something useful like your defender and your athlete. Defender being the most important, because you want to get locked down defender post style as early as possible. For your athlete, you want to be able to do little putback dunks and get your posterizer, your relentless finisher, do standing layups, and your inside scorer and your jump shooter, just so you can have other options that's not dunking, so you don't become like a DeAndre Jordan who can only dunk. Now, the next thing I want to talk to you guys about is your controls and the settings that you should be playing on. So now I want to show you guys, you know, what controls you should be using. For me anyways, I go to absolute. I turn my defensive assist strength to a 95. You can change it to 100 or 90, don't matter. And turn your box out assist strength all the way down. That does matter a lot, okay? Don't ignore what I just did there. But this is what I like to play with. It helped me get a lot of these badges. It actually helped me be a better player, to be honest, especially when playing other game modes. But just for the sake of my career, just turn your settings to these. You'll find it a lot easier later. And now time to get into the meat and the potatoes of the actual video, showing you how to get all these wonderful badges, starting with my favorite badge. Alright guys, so the first badge I want to show you guys how to get is Posterizer. So what you want to do, you want to post spin, alright? Press L2, flick the R stick, and go in for the nasty jam. It's pretty simple. Post spin is a big man's greatest tools because we don't have handles, okay? We can't dribble, so we gotta abuse that post spin as much as we can without getting stripped. But don't worry if you don't get it right the first time. Just be persistent. As you see, the defender did a nice job of containing me, but then I got around him for the second time for an easy dunk. The thing about Bruiser is a pretty nice skill because it drains the energy of your matchup pretty much throughout the whole game. So if your opponent does not have Gym Rat or something that increases your stamina, it's going to drastically affect them later on in the game. The best place to abuse this is on a fast break, because you have all types of mismatches. Alright, you see they try to reach him, but they can't get me. My handles are too sick. Going for the mean contact dunk. Finish him relentlessly. You can also get relentless finisher, by the way. Alright guys, so the next badge I want to show you guys how to get is the hardest badge to get in the game, in my opinion. And it is Offensive Crasher. You have to do so much just to get this badge, but all you need is a simple 150 offensive boards and this badge is yours. One strategy I like to use is just run the damn clock. Run it to the last like 5 seconds, get in the paint, battle for position, and grab the board. Feel free to either pass it out or throw it back up. I choose to pass it out right here. But for you guys, you might want to go ahead and just throw it back up there, because if you do, you'll find yourself with hustle points in about 80. I want to say, yeah, score off the offensive rebound about 80 times. But as you see here, I saw Westbrook was driving and I timed it perfectly. I set out the paint on purpose, all right? That way it draws the defender away, and then when they're at least expecting it, you want to just drive in on them. In this example, I'm just going to let KD do his thing, right? I you see me backing all the way out to the outside. I wait, and when I see that clock hits about like 5 seconds, I get into a paint and get into perfect position. He takes a bad shot, I grab the board, and I just yam it back in there. Easy finish, easy work. Alright, so the next badge I want to show you guys how to get is probably the most simple badge to get for your big man, especially if you can do nothing other than rebound, and that is Brick Wall. All you gotta do, just set a damn screen for the score. I'm pretty sure you do have to score off the screen, or they have to score off the screen, rather. But you know, even if they don't, just keep setting screens, and this badge will be yours. I would say about 100 screens should work. As you see, I just, you know, get the ball to him off of a nice, crossover, set a screen, and pass it to him. There's really no trick to this. You just kind of go up and set a screen. Be careful not to get the illegal screen. Watch this. Boom! Ass on the ground. That is a big man's ankle breaker. You can also get screen outlet by doing this too. I want to say about score off the screen about 30 to 50 times, and this badge should be yours in about 2 games. Alright guys, so the next badge I'm going to teach you guys how to get is Eraser. You get this badge simply by getting 80 user blocks in the season. User, not simulated. Simulated stats will not count towards your badge progress at all. All you gotta do is just block the ball. There's no real trick to it. I mean, there is, there's a few, but like, it all comes down to just memory. You know, memorizing and predicting where your opponent's gonna be. You beat that shit out the backboard, man. See, as I'm about to come over, I know the computer's about to shoot, try to get the last shot, and... Wow, okay, well, fuck me, right? It's the Cavs, why wouldn't that go in? But you see, I'm gonna kinda bait the computer right here. I see Paul Gasol thinks he has an open shot and crushes dreams like Africans on Christmas, man. Another thing you can do, if you're not as good at timing just yet, or you don't just, you know, you don't have the stats to I guess carry you, sort of say, you just want to wait till this clock goes down. All right and when it hits about 4 seconds, you just want to come up, just come out the cut, smack that shit. All right guys, so the next badge I'm gonna teach you guys how to get is Fade Ace, which is a pretty deadly tool for a power forward. All you got to do is move the L stick away from the basket, hold square or R stick, whatever, and shoot the damn ball. It's pretty damn simple. See, let me show you again. Boom, Michael Jordan's fadeaway. Legendary, deadly, don't miss. Alright, the next pitch I'm going to show you guys how to get is post step back. This is one of my personal favorite moves because it creates a lot of space between you and the defender, and it's controllable unlike the other post moves. Just in case you missed that, I'm going to show you guys again. Watch, I back this little bitch up. I can't get by him, so I just do a little step back, swish, all day. Alright, the next badge I'm going to show you guys how to get is Pulse Hopperator. Instead of, you're going to want to tap it to the left or the right of the basket. See, as I create a lot of space between me and the defender. This is for if you have, like, bad matchups, you really can't back down. Bruisers, like a Shaq-like people, you want to create a lot of space between you so they can't recover in time. Alright, so the next badge I'm going to show you guys how to get is... the post hook badge. Pretty much Hakeem the Dream, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, whatever you want to call it, you really have no control over it. But you know, all you got to do is just move your R stick towards the basket, or if you're on absolute control, just move up on the pad and it should go in pretty simply. Boom. And the last one I want to show you guys how to get is probably the hardest but definitely my favorite to do, the Dream like up and under swish. Boy, this one will fool a lot of people in the park, okay? All you gotta do, just fake like you're about to take a shot, move the R stick back one way, and then push it back the other. And, that's about it, guys. That's it. Of course, there's always some more badges you can earn for your big man. I'm still not done growing. I'm still going to be the ultimate big man, the best big man I can be. One of the moves that I suggest that you guys go ahead and get spin lay-in as well. That's a very, very, very good badge. I don't see too many people utilizing that because a lot of people buy the fake. And if you can combine that with up and under, like try this move right here that I'm about to show you. Ooh, man. You could be a force to be reckoned with. And then there's also the matter of unfazed and microwave, which I've yet to discuss in the video. Those badges are pretty simple to get, actually. To get microwave, you just have to stay on the consistent hot streak for about, I want to say, 5 games. I got double red rings, and then for unfazed, I got that in 1 game without even trying because the Cavs were pissing me off, man. I was trying to get this other badge. I think I was trying to get Lob City Finisher, and I was getting pissed because these lobs weren't, like, they weren't connecting. Like, I swear to God, they just go over your head. And, like, so I had to drop 60 on the Cavs just to bring us back and win by only 2 points. I'm like, what the fuck? And speaking of Lob City Finisher, I'm gonna have to make a completely new video on that one. But and I know a lot of you are probably saying, like, what about Drop Stepper? Honestly, I wouldn't use that badge because, like, the chances are you're gonna get ripped before you can even utilize that move, man. But seriously, I want to thank you guys for supporting me, all that you guys have been doing, man. 150 subscribers in 2 weeks, man. Like, that's more than anyone can ask for. I'm really happy. But thank you once again. Like, comment, subscribe, dislike if you didn't. And you know what? I'll be rolling out some new content real soon. So thank you and bye-bye.